Hey guys, and welcome back to another episode. Today we're going to be taking a look at Beatdown: Fists of Vengeance by Capcom, which came out for the PS2 and Xbox back in 2005. Beatdown is an action/RPG/beat-em-up game which is similar in style to Yakuza or Shenmue, just not nearly as good. But hey, it's interesting at least, and it does have some cool features that we're going to take a look at.
I don't get no respect. I got people fucking with me from all sides.
You play as one of five selectable gangsters who's been betrayed by their boss and is out looking for answers and revenge. There's lots of predictable double-crossing, drug references, and bad language abound, and really for no reason. It's just kinda there to be there.
Knock that shit off. You forget why we even came here. What about the drugs?
In Beatdown, you'll be running around the city of Los Sombras, taking on missions, getting into scuffles, buying skirts, you know, the usual kind of stuff. Your home base is The Hole, which is a seedy bar on the edge of town. You can change here, take on side missions, get updates on story progress, and of course save your game. At the top left of the screen, you'll notice two percentages. One shows your wanted level to the police, and the other is the same, but for the rival gang. These can both be lowered by changing clothes frequently. There are two different kinds of fights that you can get into in Beatdown. One is just an open world brawl, and the other is reserved for boss fights or storyline related fights. This second type will show both characters with a meter under their health bars that look like fire. Once that fire is extinguished, you can grab your opponent and finish the fight in a few different ways. The first option is to recruit, which will have them join you. You can have up to three members in a party, and this definitely helps when you're outnumbered, and this game has a tendency of making that happen way more often than I would like. You can rob them, which does exactly what you would think, and also you can interrogate, which will cause certain thugs to spill info on storyline-related quests. The last option is beatdown. Wanna guess what that does? Be careful with this option. It will raise your police awareness up really fast. You'll get experience after fights, and when you have enough to level up, you can choose to drop points into skills like stamina, attack, and technique. With enough of these points, you can talk to the bartender in the hole and ask him to teach you a new move. And that's basically it in a nutshell. Run around, get into fights, move the story along, buy some clothes, and save your game. Rinse and repeat for roughly about 8 hours or so. This wouldn't be so difficult to do if it weren't for the horrendous load times and laughable AI. Even the bosses in the game can be dispatched by just mashing the punch button over and over. Why the load times are so bad, I have no idea. Each area that you travel to is pretty darn small, and some of them will only give you a few steps to move at all before loading you into yet another area. It's amazing how much something like load times can really take you out of the experience.
Sorry, ladies and gentlemen, but I'm afraid you're right.
Graphically, the game looks dull and dark. Lots of grays, lots of browns. Some areas are so dark that it gets really difficult to see. The characters animate like awkward puppets, and they just look silly when they're fighting. Granted, some of it can be funny at times, like watching an enemy get blasted by a car in the middle of a fight, or throwing someone off an overpass. The sound is mixed too, some really good tracks here and there, but also some terrible ones that'll have you rushing to get out of the zone. Voice work is laughable, but the sound effects themselves do the job.
Oh, shit!
It and that's Beatdown Fists of Vengeance. It's really just a poor man's Yakuza. It had some potential, but the way the game is laid out is so goofy and the characters have zero charisma. The fighting itself is super bland and boring too. There's still some fun to be had here and there in small spurts, so I would tell fans of beat-em-up games to give it a go, but I really couldn't recommend it to anyone else. And hey, it's still better than Final Fight Streetwise, which makes this game look like Shenmue by comparison.
I'm surprised you made it this far. Color me impressed.
As always, guys, thank you for watching, and until next time, stay classic.
That's all you'll ever be, too!